The real-world concept of the eVTOL was first introduced to the world in 2009 by NASA, when they released a render of a single-person eVTOL, although the idea of such crafts has been present in sci-fi for a long time. However, it wasn't until 2011 when actual efforts by the industry began to take place, chasing the dream of the Jetsons. While large companies such as Boeing, Airbus, and Bell have been taking the helm on these projects, the smaller startups have been the backbone of the eVTOL movement, such as Rise Aerotech, which has seized the current realities of the now possible crafts to bring handy tools to their customers. They do so with their upcoming design, the Rise Recon. While taking cruise rides is certainly within the capabilities of the Rise Recon, it is being designed for a more noble purpose specifically. That is, to take rural users from one destination to another. Perhaps the most significant thing about eVTOLs is that they don't need to worry about the sort of barriers that helicopters or planes need to. They don't need a runway, and they require much smaller landing and takeoff points. Because of this, they will be beneficial for surveying landscapes, transporting supplies to people in traditionally difficult areas to reach, and saving lives by getting and transporting individuals in need. The projected specs for the Recon are looking pretty good too, with a weight of around 300 pounds, a max range of about 25 miles, and a max speed capping at 63 miles per hour. It will be powered by 6 independent propulsion systems, which will, in turn, be powered by their own individual removable battery packs, so you can swap them out on the fly, possibly providing more fly time. The company says their baby is specifically designed to be easily mass-produced, cheap to keep running, and clean. So easy to fly that anyone can pilot it. While prices are not available yet for those interested, Rise has stated that they have a functional prototype and will be releasing more detailed specs closer to their planned launch next year. Moving away from the rotor-type design of other up-and-coming aircraft, the AN-1 is capable of both vertical and short takeoff landing, dubbed Eve's Stoll. It's a similar operation style to the hugely successful Harrier jump jet used in the U.S. Armed Forces. It's a single-seater that uses a hybrid electric rotating propulsion system that cannibalizes the energy continuously produced by the gas turbine with a generator. The kinetic energy usually lost is collected to improve efficiency, speed, and flight range. The AN-1 model has been designed for extreme performance and competition use, with a higher theoretical top speed and altitude, whereas the AN-2 is a basic utility platform that not only seats 2 but boasts a much more comprehensive range, useful for things like urban surveillance and getting emergency services to where they need to go very quickly. Taking a different approach, the Jetson 1 is an ultra-lightweight electric vertical takeoff and landing vehicle, or eVTOL for short, that weighs less than some humans, tipping the scales at an unbelievable 198 pounds. The design brief was simple. With roads and freeways clogged up with cars, why not make the skies available to the regular Joe to travel in? The resulting prototype is made from an all-aluminum chassis with a carbon fiber seat and rotor propellers. It uses a combination of 8 brushless electric motors to carry a single pilot weighing 187 pounds up to 63 miles per hour through the air. Unfortunately, the batteries are still relatively low on capacity with a flight time of 15 minutes and a range of about 15 miles. In saying that, it's perfect for getting to the office at a blindingly fast pace, avoiding the morning peak hour standstill. Lithium batteries are old news, They're expensive to make, hard to recycle, and take a pretty massive toll on the environment. The future is hydrogen, a fuel that is readily available by using solar power to drive the electrolysis of seawater. The Maka Carcopter is looking to take advantage of this promising renewable energy technology. But first, is it a car or is it a helicopter? The answer lies somewhere in the middle. It's both. This fantastic-looking contraption can speed a single passenger around a racetrack just as quickly as through the skies. Using a similar rotor assembly to the hobby drone, the Carcopter uses a set of three double-bladed propellers to get airborne while keeping noise to a minimum. The manufacturer is hoping that no license will be necessary for operation, thanks to semi-autonomous capability. In 2012, a group of Toyota employees established the pro bono group Cartivator and began work on the SD00 shortly after. This was a scale model prototype of a flying car that the company had envisioned creating. They successfully ran driving and hovering tests with the prototype only 6 months later. Still, before they could work on the real deal, they needed to scale it up first. And so, the production of the SD01 had begun. And the new group, SkyDrive, would arise. SkyDrive was the new edition of Cartivator and would oversee the production of the SD series, such as the new SD01 project. Information on this new prototype is sparse, but it was a very early design with a metal frame, four wheels, two seats, a steering wheel, and four rotors. However, tests were a success, so SkyDrive was able to raise funding, shake hands, and make friends. So they leaped into making their goal a reality. Now you know the story, so let's get to the good stuff. The SD03 and the current project being developed, the SDXX. The SD03 made its first public demonstration in 2020 and featured a much more commercial design than the previous prototypes. The single-seat design resembles contemporary eVTOLs and measures around 13 feet long and 11 feet wide. Four rotors are evenly split between each corner. Each rotor is powered by its own motor as a fail-safe mechanism. A pilot flew for 4 minutes around 1 hectare of land during the demonstration, while a computer handled the flight stability and safety. At this point, SkyDrive has shaped up to be the leader of Japan's eVTOL scene, with many sponsorships, such as Bandai Namco and Mitsubishi. For a future project, Suzuki has teamed up with SkyDrive for a special project that looks like it could be the SDXX. Suzuki will handle things like business and technology research and development, and help with mass producing SkyDrive's next project. This means SkyDrive is left to focus on creating the best compact two-seater eVTOL possible. Although the SDXX is still in development, hence the placeholder name, it still boasts a much more striking image than its predecessor, the SD03. It adds another seat to the mix for two people to enjoy a ride in the glass-covered cabin. And because of its three wheels and land driving capabilities, it technically falls into the category of a flying car rather than an eVTOL. This is an interesting... If you enjoyed this video, you could help us out by hitting the like button, subscribe, and keep up to date on future posts.